In the past few years, gaming has become far more demanding compared to previous cycles, with Unreal Engine pushing the industry toward more ray tracing and extremely detailed geometry. The bar for playing games has certainly been raised. Not just for maxed out settings, devs have started recommending higher specs and more RAM, even for playing on medium settings. So the question is, will upgrading from 16 to 32 gigs of RAM give us a noticeable improvement in games? And if so, how much? My name is Willie and welcome to my channel. Thank you to all my subscribers for helping me get monetized and reach nearly 1900 subscribers in 2024. If you enjoy my content, consider hitting the like and subscribe buttons. Leave a comment too, because I read them all and respond to as many as I can. I'd also like to give a big shout out to my super subscriber Jordan for gifting a 1 month membership to 20 subscribers during one of my live streams. You too can become a super subscriber to get special video shoutouts and other perks. Now enough introductions, let's get right into it. For DDR4 RAM, 2 sticks of 16 or 4 sticks of 8 is far superior to 1 stick of 32. I already had 2 sticks of 8 and my motherboard has space for 4, so I simply bought a second kit to reach 32 gigs. Also, my system is pretty mid-range with a Ryzen 5 5600X CPU paired with an RTX 4070 GPU. For these tests, I chose 3 different games, each using a different game engine. This will give us a snapshot of what to expect from doubling our RAM from 16 to 32. Starting with the smash hit Marvel Rivals, this hero shooter was built in Unreal Engine 5, and I'm running it with medium settings, DLSS quality, and Lumen GI and reflections on. With 16 gigs, I was getting an average of 90 FPS, though it could dip into the 70s during intense fights. With 32 gigs, the improvement was so incredibly high, I had to double check that I was using the same game settings. With an average of 125 FPS, that's about a 40% increase in FPS. The dips in FPS were also significantly reduced, rarely going below 110. This is very good news, since many games these days are made using Unreal Engine. In UE5, Nanite and Lumen are so RAM intensive that Epic Games recommends devs use at least 32 gigabytes. Unless optimizations are implemented, we'll feel this on our side in the final game, as this result clearly shows. I'm still blown away by 40% increase, but let's move on to the next game. Helldivers 2 has been a regular testbed for this channel, but its engine Autodesk Stingray is discontinued, so we won't be able to extrapolate this result as well compared to Marvel Rivals. That being said, I still use this game for two reasons. Number one, it's very popular, winning Best Multiplayer Game last month at the 2024 Game Awards, and still has a daily average of 100,000 Steam users playing. And number two, it's easily my favorite game in the last 5 years, so I like to tinker with it, making videos on how to inject ray tracing, get better upscaling, or add frame gen with lossless scaling. My Helldivers 2 optimized settings guide is what launched this channel into getting monetized. With 16 gigs of RAM at native 1440p, still using the settings I outlined in that video, we're looking at an average of 80 FPS. During heavy combat, it can sometimes dip below 60 FPS, which isn't ideal. Though we are somewhat GPU bound at native 1440p. Jumping to 32 gigs, we're getting a 13% increase to 90 FPS, with dips only into the 70s during heavy combat. This is not as huge a difference as what we saw in Marvel Rivals, but still a very respectable bump in FPS. So after seeing improvements in an old engine, let's switch gears to something new, with Indiana Jones and the Great Circle. This action-adventure game is the first to use the Motor game engine, based on id Tech 7, which was used for Doom Eternal. This game has extremely detailed environments with full ray tracing. So beyond the high CPU and GPU requirements, the devs also recommend 32 gigabytes of RAM. The main culprit for this is the texture pool size, so I turned that down to medium, maxed everything else out, and set DLSS to quality. Even so, with path tracing on, neither 16 nor 32 gigs can reach 60 FPS, with about an 8% performance gap between them. Switching to software ray tracing, we see a 15% improvement, going from 68 FPS with 16 gigs up to 78 FPS at 32 gigs. Now, after these tests, it's clear that 32 gigabytes is a solid upgrade from 16, especially since upgrading RAM is pretty cheap compared to other components in your PC. That being said, don't forget to enable XMP Profile in your BIOS. This will ensure your RAM is running at the speed it's rated for. You can easily find out if it's running at the correct speed by opening Task Manager, Control-Shift-Escape. Within the Performance tab, click on Memory and you'll see the speed right here. If it doesn't match the speed printed on the box, you'll need to open the BIOS and enable XMP. If you have an AMD system, it will be called either DOCP or XPro. And with that, let's roll the credits. If you'd like to support the channel and get featured here, consider becoming a super subscriber for extra perks, including a free super chat on my live streams. Let's give a warm welcome to all the new members. Nom nom nom. Nom nom nom. Castile, Blue Butterfly VR, Ertz, Madi, Tubular Wheat, Adam Timmons, Alejandro, Micah Sullivan, Eggy, Twingy, Dory, KKRK, Michael Nightwolf, Leo Ree Kato, Raccoon Man Thing, Dusted Taint, SOEMK, Raymond Ponce de Leon, Steve Clayson, and finally, a special shout out to my super subscriber Jordan, who gifted so many of these memberships on my stream. Thank you all for watching and supporting the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.